Previously on Paradise Cafe.
Find out what is making the coral stink and make it stop before my hotel loses any more money.
What kind of crazy operation are you running here?
Dad, honestly, it was a ghost.
Megan, you know how I feel about that kind of stuff, don't you?
Is that creepy or what?
It's like the water reveals how he really is or something.
I do not yet know that I am a sea ghost.
Wow, she looks hot.
Yeah, I wouldn't have worn wool on a day like this.
I saw her first, so she's mine.
You can't do that, it's the 21st century. Besides, if anything, I saw her first, so she's mine.
Okay, you're right. It has to be her choice. How about a contest? First one to get a kiss wins. Loser has to clean the cafe for a week.
Now that sounds like a plan, Stan. No, you spit on yours.
Oh.
It's not fall out over this year.
We're best mates, it's impossible.
After all these years of searching, all these years of blaming myself for what happened, could it really be you?
Paradise Cafe, the finest smoothie bar on this here island. Anything take your fancy?
Robbo, I was just...
Ah, what can I do for you, huh? Little sis? Anything at all?
What are you...
Play along.
You're so funny. You're the best. We're so close. You wouldn't believe how much she looks up to me.
Get off me, you big freak. What's all that rubbish for?
I was impressing her with my loving side, and you totally ruined it. I'll get you back for this, you know.
Yeah? When?
Megan, I'm like a goldfish. I never forget.
That's an elephant, you dingbat.
Yeah, whatever. The point is... What did you want, anyway?
To remind you to keep an eye out. Remember what Hector said? There are ghosts all over the place now, and some of them aren't too nice.
Megan, please, give me some credit. I think I'll know a ghost when I see one. Hmm, that's a good one. I'll have to watch out for you.
Abby, I've made a decision. Since you seem to think that cafe is so amazing, I've decided to invite your little friend to dinner.
What?
At the apartment, tonight. You're invited too, of course.
Hang on a sec. Little friend?
You have done well to earn the children's trust, Chloe. But now you must exploit that trust.
What is your bidding, Ragnar?
I need the Seaborn's body. With it I can escape my coral prison and be free. Find me the Seaborn. I am sure it is one of the children.
But how can I tell which?
The seal. Whoever broke the seal on the coral, that is who you seek.
Sweet little girl, I've been thinking.
What are you doing?
Trying to look intelligent and deep.
Girls like that, eh?
See the way she's checking me out? It's basic psychology, Tai, so buzz off or you'll spoil him. What are you doing?
Copying you.
No offense, mate. There's tons of stuff you do really well, but intelligent and deep isn't one of them.
Man, she doesn't know that.
Trust me, your face gives it away. This is ridiculous. She probably thinks we're a couple of idiots now. Way to go, Tai.
Man, that was a stupid idea anyway.
Stupid that you tried it, maybe. Get your own ideas in future, if you have any. Where does she go?
I believe I have found him. The one we have sought for so long. Come to me, my clan brothers. But wait for my final word. When I am sure it is truly he, we will make him pay for his lies and treachery.
Robbo's driving me crazy about this girl we both like. I think I need some advice. Like, love advice?
What do I know about love?
Well, you're a girl. Kind of?
No, Tai, not kind of, actually.
So, what do girls look for in a guy?
Well, being kind, considerate, caring and understanding.
Man, that sounds hard.
Okay, how about be confident, dress snappy and pay for stuff.
Now that I can do. Thanks a bunch, you little potato pie.
Will you guys stop doing that?
Mind if I take a seat?
Aye, please do. I'm Shauna. So, what's your name then? And your friend. Tell me about him.
Ah, he's no one. Don't worry about him. I'll get us a drink.
Tai, you look ridiculous.
Ridiculously good, you mean?
Is that for her?
Her name's Shauna, and she's in the mood for some Tai.
Just give it up, will you? I was making real progress before you came in.
Man, don't be a sore loser. You had your chance, mate. Now just let me do my thing.
I just can't believe it. I mean, you. Over me. It's just crazy.
You did that on purpose.
Well, duh.
I don't want to ever see you again.
Good. I don't even need you, Tai, you loser.
Whatever.
You're a ghost.
I wasn't sure if it was you at first. Your disguise is very good. But after seeing the nasty way you treated your friend, I know I was right. Only you could be so mean.
I don't... What?
I've contacted my father's fallen clansmen. The ones that died because of you. Come nightfall, they'll lay siege to this tavern.
Didn't sound good.
Megan, what's this about you accepting a dinner invite from my mum?
I was just being polite.
Listen, I've worked very hard to keep work, my mum, and play, my friends, and everything else separate. This dinner could mess that all up.
Hang on, did you just call me your friend a second ago?
No, as if. And I'd appreciate it if you kept focused here.
Okay. What do you want me to do?
For a start, don't be you. I have a rep to protect.
I can do that.
Just don't be polite. Respond only with snorts and grunts. If you can manage it, sarcasm. It's very important tonight goes badly and she comes away hating you. We've got a lot to do, Megan. A lot to do.
Hey, Robbo. Hey, check this out. Look, two coral samples. One from last week, one from today. See how much worse today's one is. But why? You okay?
Well, there's a slight problem. And I know you don't entirely believe in ghosts and stuff, but
Go on.
Nah, it's nothing. No big deal.
Are you sure? You can tell me.
Yeah, thanks, Dad. I'm good.
Well, whatever it is, I'm sure you'll think of something. Just use your brains.
Yeah. Use my brains.
Please, please, please don't do it. I beg you, call off the attack.
Give me one good reason why I should, Ethan.
Okay, one reason. How about...
I'm not Ethan. That's not my name.
Oh, you're not, are you?
But that's not me. I swear.
I know you only too well, Ethan. I will send the men the final word as punishment for your cowardly actions. They'll wipe your cafe from the face of the island. And you with it.
Way to make things crazy bad worse, Robbo.
Hello, Robbo. Fancy seeing you here.
What, outside the cafe?
Yeah. Anyway, about the coral.
Sorry, Chloe. I don't have time. There's someone I really need to see.
Well, that was a bit not awesome.
Anna, are you looking for Tai? How am I? I'll get you a drink. Now, tell me what the problem is.
You believe in ghosts, right?
Got no choice, have I? This island's full of them. This book? This book tells you all about them.
Whoa. Who's that?
Ah, the great Seaborne. And his arch-enemy, the evil Taonga Ragnar.
Taonga? Is that like a sorcerer?
Now, 1,000 years ago, Ragnar's evil was destroying our island until a being born of the sea defeated him, stripped him of his human form, and banished him to an ocean prison. But one day Ragnar could return, and a new Seaborn will make himself known. This person must prove themselves worthy to assume their powers, or they risk defeat by Ragnar, and the island will be doomed.
Where's this prison thing, then?
What's he doing here?
Is that how you greet your visitors, is it? You and Robbo have a good talk while I go and get us all something to eat.
Well?
That Shona girl? She's a ghost. And she thinks I'm this guy, Ethan. She's going to destroy the cafe, and...
You need my help.
Actually, yes.
Well, you know what you need to see.
Whatever then. Never mind.
Why'd you even come?
To check you're still an idiot. So mission accomplished.
Hello, Tai. Fancy seeing you here.
This is my house, Chloe.
Oh, it is. Anyway, about that time you went diving with Robbo and Megan.
Sorry, not now, Chloe. Have the ghosts arrived yet?
Any minute now.
Guess I'm trapped then. So the ghost had Ethan's picture in a locket. That's a bit weird, isn't it?
They were in love.
That's why he hurt her so much. He betrayed their love. What about this? What if you just pretend to be Ethan and just apologize for everything?
Should I dress like him too?
Scottish? Yeah, bro. What the heck? What have we got to lose?
Let's give you a new look for the dinner.
I guess you could say that I need a...
One more thing. Maybe we should turn some lights off.
You know what? I really think this could work.
Remember, if you can't convince Shona that you're truly sorry, then the cafe will be toast before you can say Loch Ness Monster. But no pressure. And these Highlanders, they don't wear pants. Think about that.
Why are you dressed like that?
I'm going to dinner at Abby's.
But why are you dressed like her?
Because she asked me to. And because I want her to like me. She's older, you know. Cooler. Maybe some of it will rub off on me.
So, you know, I've been thinking about that time you and Robbo and Tai went diving, and who did you say it was who broke the seal?
I didn't. I think we were all touching it. Probably how it broke.
Do you really want to dress like Abby?
No. It doesn't feel like me.
Well, then you should be true to yourself.
Where's Shona? I can't apologize and stop them if she isn't even here.
We have to hold them off till she gets here. We need more stuff, Robbo!
Here! The chairs! They're getting in! Hide in the kitchen!
Watch out! I've got this one. You go.
Ethan, you're putting up a valiant fight.
But a useless one.
Please, call it off. I'm sorry for denying who I am. I was stupid to even try. Of course I'm Ethan. I'm also sorry for betraying your clan all those years ago. And I'm especially sorry for betraying your love.
I waited for you so long. But then in the morning we were ambushed on the coastal trail. No one survived. All drowned. Only you knew we would be there. Only you could have betrayed us. Why did you betray the clan? Why did you betray me?
They're gone.
Yeah. You better run. Hey. What's up? They were just messing with us. They could get in all along.
No. Listen, Shona, okay? I'm not Ethan. I'm Robbo. And I know you're angry and you want answers, but I don't know why he did what he did. We all say and do stuff in the heat of the moment. And afterwards, we don't know why we did it. But you don't know who your real friends are until you need them the most. So I'm sorry, mate. Honest. It wasn't your fault Ethan betrayed you and your people died. It was a choice he made, so you shouldn't blame yourself. But destroying the cafe won't bring your people back. And in the long run, it probably won't make you feel any better.
I accept now that you are not Ethan. You're too honest and true to be him. Let us go and leave this place be. Thank you for helping me finally see the truth, Robbo.
And being on the isolated beach hasn't hurt business at all?
No, it's the opposite. People like the seclusion. It's the one place on the island that feels like paradise.
Interesting. Very smart little friend you've got here. Very smart.
Yeah, that's great.
All three? One of them is the Seaborn. We must find another way to uncover who it is.
Well, it will not be easy.
I must escape this coral prison. I must be free. Do not fail me!
Man, I can't believe we nearly fell out over a girl. She wasn't even a real girl in the end.
Yeah, a couple of idiots we are. Hang on. She kissed me. So I won.
Won what?
The contest. We shook on it. First one to get a kiss wins. That means you have to clean the cafe.
Bro. After everything we've been through. Come on, buddy.
Yeah, but we shook on it.
Here's your prize. A bath.